Okay, how's everybody doing today? I figured since I had a little extra time, I would show off a little video of the Bespin gantry. So here is some close-ups of it. And I have my DX07 Luke Skywalker battle damaged up against the Hot Toys Empire Strikes Back Vader, which I love. I think he's probably the best looking one just because of all the stuff he comes with. I love the gloves, the helmet, wish it stayed on better, but I'll tell you, Jazz Inks does absolutely incredible stuff. I did have a little bit of an issue with this piece right here. Came in originally, one of these was broken. You know, stuff happens in shipping. And then this piece right here was broken too. So he sent me out another one. Unfortunately, this is the second one and it was broken as well. And I just figured to save him some hassle and to save me some wait time, I repaired it with some epoxy glue, which he suggested. And all in all, I think it'll be okay. I was a little bummed, but I do understand stuff like that happens. What are you gonna do? And I was kind of cramped on space to put this, and I wanted it very badly. So I do have it mounted on the wall. And because of the way my condo is, Sean helped me out, and we kind of mounted that up there in that peak, and then it was his idea to use whatever was left over to go all the way down there, which I think was an awesome idea. Love it. And if anybody decides to order this, on Jazz Inc's website, the wall anchors, they tell you the ones that they have are not for sheetrock. I would agree 1000%. What I used was some easy anchors. Each one holds 50 pounds. I've got seven of them in there because I missed on one right there. But at any rate, got more than enough. And then I didn't want to see the silver screws, so I put these little, if I can get it open, little banner caps, cover them up, get them at Lowe's, a couple bucks. I think that looks really good. All in all, I am overly impressed with this gantry. It's something, you know, it's just a visual centerpiece. And I am working on some lighting. I got these puck lights. Came through to a pack, they have different colors, and I wanted to get more, so I went and bought another pack, but unfortunately I can't get the same remote to work them all. I gotta figure out how to make that work, but I'll work on that. And if you do get it though, I would be very careful with these rail pieces. They're very snug, and you have to be very delicate pushing them in. I did end up kind of breaking two of them, but they were nice clean breaks and I super glued them back together and shouldn't have any issues. I'm not planning on doing a lot of wiggling this stuff around from here on out. Just kind of wanted to get it where I want it and then just let it be. Does come with two sets of these, one set uncut, this set cut. Gotta have the cut ones no matter what. Pan around over here. Let's see.
mean, this is just, this is something that I've always thought would be awesome. As soon as I saw the Bespin Luke, when I first started collecting, I was like, oh man, it'd be so awesome to have, like, you know, the bridge where they fought, or even, you know, before I even found out about Jazz Inc., the, some of the other iconic things. I am really, really bummed that I did not get the meditation chamber. That's another piece that I would love to get a hold of. Because I am a pretty big fan of Vader. So. Well, I think I'm going to go ahead and end this video. To give you an idea, if you don't have it, haven't seen it, this gantry is approximately 45 inches wide, left to right. It is, I believe, 23 and some change tall, and it probably is because of that rocket ship piece on the side. And then when you have it mounted and off the wall, it's, know exactly, but I'd probably say that's a foot and a half off the wall. And if you like this stuff, you can go to Jazz Inc. Dioramas. Guy Yost is an amazing guy. He is very responsive, very accommodating, and his attention to detail is like none other. When he makes something, he makes it movie accurate. He has many different things in the works that collectors would be interested in. Mostly Star Wars, but he is venturing into some Marvel and DC stuff. Most of his stuff is for the IKEA Detolfs and Vestas and Stuvas, but he does do some freestanding stuff like this and other things he has in the works. All right, well, I'm gonna go ahead and end this video. Hope you like it. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. I'll try to answer them as quick as possible. Thanks a lot. Enjoy.